My first experience with a spirit was extremely terrifying. This is what happened. So this is part two. I'm going to pick up where I left off in the last video, where there were two spirits standing in the middle of my living room and I ran out of my house completely freaked out. As I mentioned in the last video, I ran out of my house and I called the only person that I could think of calling was my therapist. So when I got to her office, I was still completely freaked out. And I was telling her everything that was going on and what I experienced, and just watching her cool calmness freaked me out even more. I was like, why doesn't this person think I'm crazy? So I proceeded to tell her that I think that I was in psychosis and that I needed some help. She asked some questions, did some evaluation, and said, I don't think you're in psychosis. You're having a spiritual awakening. This was a licensed mental health counselor. Out of all the therapists that I chose to work with, the one that I picked was somebody that was heavily involved in the spiritual community. So when she told me I was having a spiritual awakening, I didn't know what that was, and I asked her, how do I stop it? How do I make this go away? And that's when she went into more detail about what a spiritual awakening is. And for the next 2 hours, we talked about spirituality. Well, it was mostly her talking and me listening and asking questions. At the end of it, I still felt a little freaked out because I didn't know when and where I was going to see these spirits again and if I was going to start to see more of them. But after the conversation with her, I felt so much more grounded and safe. After our visit, I ended up going home where I didn't see the spirits anymore, but I definitely felt their presence. But even though I could feel them present, the rest of the evening was uneventful. I went to sleep, and in the morning when I woke up, that's when things got a little strange again. When I woke up in the morning, I could still feel the presence of these spirits, and now I started to hear these two voices speaking in the back of my head. And I began to engage with them and ask questions and talk to them, and I started to get a lot of answers back. I found out that these were my spirit guides and that they wanted to help me. And for the next 3 days, I channeled all kinds of information. I filled up 3 notebooks full of stuff that they were talking to me about. I had asked so many questions in those 3 days that the information that I was getting back filled up all of those notebooks. When I finally did leave my house, it was like every spirit in existence knew that I had left and started talking to me at once. It was kind of like going throughout the day with headphones on, blaring heavy metal music 24/7. It was exhausting. Out of time, let me know if you want me to go to a part 3.